Right, folks, being contacted by someone all the way from Haiti. Now, what they want to know is what sort of PA will they need for 5,000 people? First question, is it inside or is it outside? Because if it's inside, you probably won't need as much sound system as you would outside, because basically sound travels in that direction. So, if you're inside, it'll travel that direction, it'll hit a wall and then it'll bounce back and it will just bounce inside the room. If, though, alternatively, you're outside, it'll travel that direction and it'll just carry on going. So you do need more sound if you're outside. So what I'll do, I'll pause the camera and I've got a bit of a diagram here, give you a general idea. Now, I've worked on the principle of just looking at one side. So in other words, what you need to do is look at the one side and just do exactly the same the other side. Hold tight. Right, first off, okay, here we go. First of all, you've got your music source, CD players, MP3s, turntables, doesn't matter. They'll go into your mixer. Out of your mixer are balanced cables left and right into this unit here. This is known as a DBX drive rack PA. What that will actually do, that will EQ the sound for you. It's a limiter, compressor. It's absolutely everything. It's a crossover as well. And I'm pretty sure it will do anything up to four-way stereo. Quote me there if I'm wrong, but I'll have a look. What I'll do, I'll put the link to the side of the video. Now, you'll notice here, we're just going to look at one side. So whatever I do this side, on this side, would be exactly the same on the other side. So bass, mid, and treble on, let's say, the left side would be exactly the same right. Bass, mid, and treble on the right side. So first of all, let's go down and follow the bass line. Now, what we're doing here, have you noticed we're going to three amplifiers? Now, what you can actually do, even though an amplifier or a power amp, 9 times out of 10, is stereo, what you can do, you can link the amplifiers. So you can go, basically, into this amplifier, onto the one side, you can link it into the other side, and then you can go out of that side, into one side of the second amplifier, link it to the second side of the second amplifier, then out of the second amplifier, into one side of the third amplifier, out of the other side, or sorry, out of the same side of the third amplifier, into the second side of the third amplifier. So what's actually happened now, you've got these three stereo amplifiers, and all of a sudden they've just become one huge side, left-hand side, for these guys here, the bass cabs. Now, again, this is only an idea. Now, what I've got here are twin 18-inch bass cabs, so there'd be two 18-inch in each one of these, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 18-inch. Now, ideally, you want to get something known as long throw cabs. Now, the reason being is because with 5,000 people, you're going to have a lot of people standing at the back and they want to hear the sound. A long throw will actually throw the bass a lot further than just normal run-of-the-mill disco speakers with an actual speaker against the front of the actual unit. Long throw, you find the speaker could be, say, here, and you have this horn, and then the front of the speaker is about here. So what happens is the sound will vibrate inside the horn and it will actually get louder. That's quite important. Now, what I suggest you run something like this on, again, it's only suggestion, are the Macrotech series. They're by Crown, and each one of those amps, it's the 3600 VZs, will run at 1,565 watts a side at 4 ohms. So basically, you would have near enough 369 kilowatts per side on bass. Now we'll go to the mid, not the mid and top, just the mid. What we've done here, we've run to two amplifiers, and these are the Crown Macrotech 3600s again. So what we've got here, we have got twin 15s, again, if you want to, horn loaded. So what we do, we would actually have one amplifier here running two, and the other amplifier running two, and all of this will be run at 4 ohms quite nicely. And then the top, what we'd be looking at here, another two boxes, and here maybe some 8-inch horn loaded and some 2-inch compression drivers as well. And these guys here would be run on Crown MA2402s. They're the Macrotech. Now, they will actually push out 800 watts a side at 4 ohms. So you're looking at 1.6K per amplifier. So, if we add all of that up, that is roughly 18.2k per side. So, double that, and that's 20, 36.4, which is, it sounds a lot of power, and it is one hell of a lot of power, but what you have to remember is 5,000 people will soak up a great deal of bass. Also, ideally, if you think about it, these guys here, the mid and top, are going to be quite high, because you need this sound to travel. Bass is omnidirectional anyway, so it doesn't matter so much about the bass. Also, very quickly, if you're going to have a unit like this, make sure it's very well secured, because that's going to rumble quite a bit. You don't want these falling all over the place. Alternatively, what you can do, you can get flying frames. Now, if you've ever seen any huge big events, you'll see sometimes they'll have huge arrays above the bass cabs, and they're actually flown. Now, the beauty about that is they're really high, and the sound will travel a lot further. The bass, 9 times out of 10, they'll have that on the floor. So here's a general idea for you. Again, quote me here if I'm wrong. And like I said earlier, you may not need as much power if you're inside, but definitely if you're outside, even 18.2k per side for 5,000 people sounds a lot, but once the crowd's going and the volume starts to turn up, you'll wonder where all the actual power is going. Alright, hope it's been a bit of a help for you. Practice and enjoy.